And good evening, Southeast Texas. Continuing to see indications that Laura is steadily intensifying, and that pace may increase to rapidly intensifying, something we don't want to see. But as you can see, Marco going by Southeast Texas right now. That's one of the reasons I don't think this is going to weaken as it heads towards our area generally. We are going to have a tropical air mass overhead. You can see Marco's some of the rotation there from what's left of it, but some showers moving over towards, we'll go with Maryville, how about that? And back over along the Sabine River, Oberlin, Louisiana. So Rita, it was a 5 at one time, but it weakened as it came ashore. I learned something in that. Dry air was over the coast, the entire Gulf Coast. And as the storm moved closer to the coast, it entrained or ingested that dry air. Hurricanes don't like dry air. When that happened, the storm weakened. With Marco over us, this very humid tropical air mass over our area, it's going to be in Laura's path the next day or so. So I don't think this is going to weaken as far as that goes. First off, let's take a look and look at the indications. We're starting to get an eye right there. You can see in just the last couple frames, starting to get that eye. This deep, dark purple, those are hot towers going up. Very intense updrafts, and that means convection is very well established. Also, you can see maybe some striations right there. That's also an indication of high pressure. Water temperature is certainly warm enough, 87, 88, 89 degrees out in the central Gulf of Mexico. And here's the official track, the latest track from the National Hurricane Center, becoming a Cat 2 tonight, and then taking aim somewhere along the upper Texas Gulf Coast. Looks like a Cat 3 coming in towards the mouth of the Sabine River overnight tomorrow night. And now, again, this track could change. This could be stronger if it goes west, and there's still the potential of that, but that's where we're at right now. It heads through Southeast Texas and weakens. It's very similar path to Rita back in 2005, and then with Ike, a similar path back in 2008. Regardless, all of Southeast Texas, Southwest Louisiana in a hurricane warning. That means winds of 74 miles an hour or greater are expected, and with a Cat 3, winds of 111 to 129 miles an hour possible. There are some models trying to go to a Cat 4, speculation, but we'll go with the Hurricane Center, but don't put that out of the realm of possibilities. Regardless, looks like a high probability as far as seeing tropical storm force winds at 100% chance of that happening, 39 to 73 mile per hour. And it looks like hurricane force winds probability of about 50% as the storm moves through Southeast Texas right now. This is the power outage index, something new, and it looks like a severe power outage across Southeast Texas because of the winds. A storm surge warning is in effect, basically from Galveston, including Port Arthur, back over towards, we'll go with the Atchafalaya River Basin. So again, the exact track will dictate whether you're on the dirty or the clean side. Dirty side, 9 to 13 feet. This water could move 20, 25 miles inland. Look at that. Sabine River going to get 9-foot storm surge in there. And as you can see, Bridge City, orange, back up the Neches River. That forces all the water up through the Sabine Lake and up into both the Sabine and Neches River. There is quite a bit of chatter, I won't say chatter, but will there be water over the seawall? There's a potential for that. Obviously, if this tracks east or west, that will change this forecast. But as you can see, water will likely at this point move in towards 73, 365, and then up the Hillebrand Bayou in towards South Beaumont. And that's the way it's looking at this point. Otherwise, anywhere from 2 to 7 inches of rainfall now was forecast with this. These scattered showers that we're seeing are all the result of Marco, the remnants of Marco, pressing through Southeast Texas. We'll see easterly winds and northeasterly winds coming up tomorrow. And I think by late tomorrow afternoon, we ought to start seeing some of the outer feeder bands moving on in. That's when we'll probably start seeing tropical force storm winds across Southeast Texas. Here's the Euro showing the track a little bit further west than the Hurricane Center. That's still in the realm of possibilities, but you can see here are the also the wind gusts showing quite an impressive wind event across Southeast Texas. That means quite a bit of power outages, a lot of trees down the way it looks. So again, by early evening, we ought to start seeing tropical storm force winds in the triangle. I don't think they'll get there till about 10 or 11 in the triangle. Again, these are very rough estimates than the hurricane force winds later tomorrow night in the triangle. So tonight, 40% coverage because of the remnants of Marco moving through, otherwise mostly cloudy, very warm and humid. Tropical air mass, because of Marco, is over our area. And then tomorrow it means very humid. High temperatures before the big stuff comes in into the lower 90s. We'll give it a 70% coverage. It's not going to rain all day, but we'll start to see feeder bands late in the day. Extended forecast, we'll go with 15 to 40 coming up through the day tomorrow. That's through about 6 p.m. After 6 p.m., we'll start to see things ramping up. And I think top winds, 85 to 115. Hopefully that's all we get coming up Wednesday night. Still Thursday morning in the Triangle, 12 to maybe 60 miles an hour. Some wind gusts in the morning, but things will be leveling out as we progress through the afternoon hours, late morning and to the early afternoon hours across the area. So it won't be all day. That's the good news. And then we'll be left with a very tropical air mass, no capping, daytime heating. We'll produce scattered showers and thunderstorms, and hot, humid, tropical weather conditions will persist right on through the weekend in Southeast Texas.